Hey guys, Jake from 8020 Media here. We went ahead and ran the codes on this F350 with the 7.3 Powerstroke, and we have a P1747 engine code as well as a generic P1876 engine code here. If you guys haven't ever scanned transmission codes before, I went ahead and recorded a video on how to scan transmission codes using the 4Scan app for 7.3 Powerstrokes. But basically, whenever your overdrive light is flashing, so on your gear selector, there's overdrive and then there's a little off indicator. Whenever this off indicator is flashing and your vehicle's turned on, that indicates that you have transmission error codes stored within your engine's computer. And you can't read transmission error codes using just a general OBD2 scanner. You have to use a specific application like this right here that's called 4Scan. On here, we now have a P1747, which is for the EPC solenoid. It is EPC solenoid short circuit. And then I have a generic electronic module engine code P1876 here, which is transfer case two-wheel drive solenoid circuit open or short to ground. Now, this code is likely being caused by the P1747. In this video, I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys how to fix a P1747 error code and talk about a few of the things that can cause this as well. First of all, this error code points specifically to the EPC solenoid. The EPC solenoid sits within the solenoid pack within the transmission. The first thing that can cause this is actually having a faulty EPC solenoid in the transmission. A second thing that can cause it is just bad wiring, having a wiring issue with the wiring pack that goes to the solenoid. And then the third thing that can cause it could be a bad torque converter. I hope the torque converter is not the problem on this truck. There is a way to pull the solenoid pack and to test the solenoid pack. I went ahead and purchased a new EPC solenoid. The EPC solenoid sits on the whole transmission solenoid pack, so you can't just replace the EPC solenoid, you have to replace the whole pack. I'm going to get underneath the car here, show you guys how to get to it, show you guys how to replace it, and hope that that new solenoid pack is going to fix my P1747 error code here. Now, the solenoid packs brand new are probably about $350 to $400. It's pretty difficult to find a brand new one, and so there are a lot of rebuilt options out there. You can get a rebuilt one for $150 to $250. I have a rebuilt one that's on its way in right now, but to access the solenoid pack, you have to drop the transmission fluid pan. So I went ahead and dropped the pan on here. If you guys don't know how to do that, I just recorded a DIY on that, so that should be up on the channel. But now with that off, I'm gonna go ahead and jump underneath the vehicle, show you guys where the transmission solenoid pack is and how to remove it and replace it. All right guys, so we are underneath the vehicle right now. I have the transmission pan removed, which sits right here. Taking the transmission pan off is extremely easy. And if I didn't mention, this is the 4R100 transmission. Basically, to take this off, you're gonna drain the transmission fluid, which I've already done. There is a simple bolt on the bottom of the pan to drain the fluid, and then there's probably like 15 10 millimeter bolts that go around this, and once you remove those bolts, it just pulls right off. But now looking at this, this is your solenoid pack right here, this orange thing. And so the solenoid pack is held in with a 10 millimeter nut right here that I've already removed. And then it has maybe 8 T30 bolts right here. And then we've got another, I believe, 10 millimeter over here. So I'm gonna go ahead and remove all of these bolts right here. And then the solenoid pack should pretty easily just pull right off of here. And then it's pretty simple to get a new one bolted on up in here. But I'm gonna go ahead and get this one pulled off. I'll show you the replacement that I have, and then I'll go ahead and talk a little bit more about the problem and how to fix it. All right guys, so I got all the bolts out. It was 2 10 millimeters, and then there were 8 T30s to pull out. It is not ready to come down yet because the electrical connector is still connected to it. But I went ahead and took the bolts off first, because what that does is it loosens it a little bit. And so it lets all of the rest of the transmission oil kind of seep out of here first, whereas If you take it all off at once without the connector on there and actually pull it down, you're gonna get a bunch of transmission fluid that's gonna fall on your face. And I did make quite a mess on the ground down here, so I would probably recommend putting a towel down if you're gonna do it. What I wanna show you guys right now is the electrical connector. When I was sitting inside the truck talking about a couple things that could be causing this EPC solenoid air code, I talked about the wiring. So here you can see right up under here is the electrical connector, and then the wiring goes all the way upwards from there. And so that is the electrical connector that needs to be removed for this to fully drop out of there. And then that is the wiring that goes all the way back up there that you'll want to check as well to make sure there's no issues with that that might be causing this code. I'm gonna go ahead and get that electrical connector removed and get this complete thing dropped out of here. And right now I'm just waiting on my remanufactured solenoid pack to show up. So once that shows up, I'll show it to you. I'll pop it in here and we'll see if this fixes the code. I got my remanufactured solenoid pack in. It is the one here on the right. So I'm gonna go ahead and throw this one back up in there and see how it works. Just one note on uninstalling this. Once you get the clip off right here, it does just come out, but there is, as you can see, a O-ring that sits around the sensor. And so it does require a little bit of force to pull it to get it off there. And it also requires a little bit of force to push it all the way back up on there. It just takes a little bit of force, but should come off once you have all those bolts removed. And now putting it back in is virtually the same process. We're just gonna go ahead and get this pressed up through there. You can lubricate the O-ring with a little bit of transmission fluid to help it slide up there a little bit easier. And then other than that, it's just putting all these bolts back in, doing the electrical connector back up. And then from there, we've got to get our transmission pan back on there. If I didn't mention it before, it's always a good idea to replace the transmission fluid filter as well as the gasket that holds the transmission pan on there while you're doing this. So I've got a new filter, I've got a new gasket. So I'm gonna go ahead and throw this back on there. I'm gonna go ahead and get everything bolted back up, fill it up with transmission fluid, and then let's see how that works.